So here we'll start our walkthrough of the new Catalina 385. This is the new linear design cabinets. Plenty of storage in the galley. Two burner stove and oven. Nice deep sinks. This is refrigerator freezer. And over here in the corner is an optional ice box. That you can have a refrigeration unit installed. Air conditioning duct right here, and all the ductwork is located directly behind the panels so that you can't see it. All natural teak. I mean, it's a teak, solid teak battens on the rail. Here are two cabinets with multi-drawer storage. A Formica countertop so you can set drinks onto. This area right in here is where the stereo system would go, speakers. And a 110 outlet plug. Like all Catalinas, this unique table setting makes into a berth, or you can use it as a morning dinette. Sit down and have a cup of coffee and a little breakfast, or play some cards. Here we're showing the solid teak trim around the outside of the cabinets and this heavy-duty splash rail. A Moen faucet. The Moen faucet actually lifts right out so that you can spray or wash your hair if you want to. This is the engine box. It's all wood naturally, and there's a place on the top for to check the oil. Nav station on the starboard side with a seating area on the side, and there's a place for a laptop. This is one of the new panels that we're building on the 385 and the 355 and the 445. You're able to read your amp hours, what the draw is in the boat. And this particular boat all has LED lighting, so it cuts down on those amp hours. I have everything lit here. And you can see the number of amps we're drawing, very little. This other cabinet here houses any additional instruments. Here we have the AC-DC switch, and we also have the air conditioning, and also there's a spot for a generator. This particular boat here has the dinette conversion package, which will give you a full dinette arrangement. And this, with the optional cushion package, will make into a berth. This just drops down and folds down. The table is solid teak, and as you can see as we pull this out, it makes a really easy. Makes a nice dining table. It's out of the way, and also a cocktail table. Get out of the way here a little bit so you can see that full table. Pretty unique item. This is offered also on the 355 and the 445, and it's been an outstanding addition to the boat. Also, as you can see, the LED lights throughout the boat. These draw very little amps. Good open windows and a grab rail around the outside. Opening port here. Two opening ports over the galley. Nice window treatment here. And a full hatch above the main salon. This particular boat has air conditioning, and then these are the air conditioning vent that blows out, pushes out a lot of cold air. Teak veneer bulkhead. This is where the TV would mount. And then the floor is a Lansol floor. It's teak and holly, impervious to any areas you might want to drop a hammer or a winch handle, anything like that. And underneath these settees, that's the hot water heater here. And over here, this area here, is a nice drawer unit that pulls out. Pretty unique. Now as we leave the main salon, we'll walk into the V-berth area. As you notice, these are solid teak doors and a metal rim. No other manufacturer has this type of system. As you go forward, you see the nice big drawer bank underneath here for storage. Cabinets above for storage. And again, that teak bat material around the outside. Little makeup table. This particular boat has the optional lifting bed, which is the button right here. This just raises right up. So it makes a very comfortable area to read at night. Plenty of ventilation overhead. Nice big louvered door cabinet. And again, you've got some storage units down here. Full spring mattress. Another unique item is the boat has red lighting throughout the boat for night vision purposes. And then underneath this bed would be the storage of your tanks. Now we'll walk into the head area. Nice big head. This is an electric head with a macerator pump. There's a two drawer opening here. Nice tall shower stall. And this is a fully enclosed IGU unit, so it's easy to keep clean. Nice tall medicine cabinet. A spa type head with a bowl. And again, night lighting throughout. This drain here goes into a collection box so that you can easily clean it out when you want to. Get all the hair and soap suds and soap residue without being pumped overboard. The shower handle comes off, so you can sit down if you need to take a shower or clean your feet. Nice big head though, and it's a two-door access. And as we move out of this area and move again through the main salon, we'll come to the rear of the boat, which is the rear stateroom. Again, the solid teak doors with the metal door frame. Here we have a nice big storage cabinet. And again, the teak accent battens. These are all solid teak too. They're not fake. And this is your air conditioning return duct here. And it's a pretty nice wide open space back here. Very comfortable for sleeping for two people. Good lighting. And you have a curtain drawn over the hatch, so that you can have that little extra hours of snooze. This is where the filters are. Pretty unique system. Just open this drawer unit up and all the filters are located behind the engine, so that we call this the day locker. Water, antifreeze. So you got complete access through here. So again, this is the new 385. A quick look at the interior. Again, as we move through the boat, the linear cabinets. Another unique situation on the galley here is that you have plenty of storage. As you can see, this is from the boat show, so we have some of the items left over. This is for cups, saucers, and glassware, fully organized. Nice microwave oven. And then this is a dry food locker here to carry all your dry foods in. Cereals, bread, easy in that order. So that's the quick look at the new 385 on the interior. Thanks for coming aboard.